Okay guys, welcome to another series of 2JZ 2sday. My name is Michael Chung and today I'm going to talk about is compression ratio part 2. If you guys still have not watched the previous video about compression ratio part 1, please go ahead and watch it before you watch this video so that you can understand more from this video. Okay, so the previous video I talked about is the total volume is equals to the swept volume plus the clearance volume. Alright, so like I said in the previous video, the clearance volume including the volume of the cylinder head, the gasket and the piston, but these two things, the volume of the piston and the volume of the cylinder head, cannot be calculated. It must be measured. So I've got some of the value from the internet from this guy, and then all the credits is to him. Okay, the GE volume of the cylinder head is this. Volume of the piston of the GE is 8.66 cc. So allow me to explain a bit more about this formula. It's very simple. The volume of the gasket is just the volume of a cylinder, pi over 4 times bore square times thickness. But all of them must be in cm so that you can get cc. Alright, so this is how you can use my Excel sheet. This one I'll be putting up a link for it. I'll be preparing this link for you, for you guys to play around. So I'll let you know how you use this Excel file for your enjoyment and for your upgrade performance planning. Alright, so let's go through the 2JZ GE first. Alright, the GE has stroke 86 mm. The volume of the cylinder head, this one is I get this data. The thickness of the head gasket is just 0.4 mm, but this one you have to convert to cm when you calculate cc. The bore still 86. Then after using the volume of the gasket formula, you can get 2.32 cc. Alright, so here it is. I just repeat everything. The bore is 86 mm. The volume of the piston, okay, this one, the piston, the original piston for the 2JZ GE is very shallow, so it can only contain 8.66 cc. okay, so the swept volume is the same with GE or GTE because it is the same movement for the piston since they are using the same stroke 86 mm. It is 499.56. alright, so the total is the swept volume plus volume of the gasket plus cylinder head plus the volume of the piston. Alright, so all this, okay, you can see from this formula, all swept volume plus volume of the piston plus volume of the gasket plus volume of the cylinder head. Okay, this one is the total volume. Alright, so the compression ratio is actually the total volume divided by all the clearance volume, so you can get 10.5. Alright, let's go through the GTE one. Same 86 mm. The volume of the cylinder head, okay, the thickness of this 2JZ GTE is the thickness of the head gasket is very high, 1.35 mm after squished, after compressed. It is very high because it can allow a lower compression ratio for the turbo, so you can boost up to very high boost levels. Okay, but like as I said in the previous video, high compression ratio also has its benefits too. It is crucial to find where is the balance for your turbo boost level and your compression ratio. Alright, because you cannot have high compression ratio and high boost because it will induce more knocking. But however, you can use a fuel such as E85 or even more stable fuel, so that it can resist knocking at high temperatures. Alright. Okay, the volume of the head gasket is 7.84 cc because of the high pistol of the GT is also has a dip, so it can compress more cc. Alright, so it has 14 cc. So the total cc is slightly more, but the compression ratio is so much lower, 8.5, which is stated in the original 2JZ GTE engine. Alright, so this is what we have for the original one. But if we want to look further and we play around with this Excel file, okay, let's go for this 3.4 liter stroker kit from Titan. Okay, I'm not associated with them, okay, but I'm going to use them as an example because they are very established in motorsport industry. So they have this 94mm of stroke. Okay, let's say the cylinder head is not altered at all. Head gasket, they are still using the GTE head gasket. Bore, I'll be using here. Alright, the bore can be deleted here. Okay. No, sorry, we can't because we need the bore to calculate the CC. Alright, so I'm going to do it later. Okay, let's say we use the 86.5 mm. Okay, so you can see from here. Okay, just difference by 0.01 compression ratio. 86.5 mm bore. Okay, you can. Okay, all this value I get from the internet, but I believe this one is true because I've done some testing on it too. Alright, so the volume of the piston is this. So the compression ratio is 9.17. Okay, so let's play around. If the stroker kit I'm using 3.5 liters, alright, if the stroker kit is 3.5 liters, the stroke is 97mm. So what we can get is the compression ratio is 9.43. Okay, so this one is very easy for me to just adjust. I just need to adjust some of the numbers over here, then I can get the final compression ratio. Okay, why this one is very important is because this one is when you do your selection of your fuel, of your turbo boost levels. Okay, because you want a higher stroker kit, you can get better low-end response. Okay, and also increasing the factory displacement by 0.5 liters can increase the low-end torque and the horsepower, and also reduce turbo lag too. So that means at a lower RPM, the turbo is able to produce more boost. For the original stroke 86mm, the Titan Motorsports has increased by 10mm to 96mm, sorry, it's not 97mm. Increase to 96mm, we can see the compression ratio is 9.34. Alright, so the if you buy the stroker kit, it comes together with the crankshaft too. Okay, so with proper crankshaft and the cone rods, you can rev up to very high RPM, up to 9000 RPM. This one is all depends on your camshaft selection and your lightweight waft train. Lightweight waft train includes the box springs, retainers, all has to be lightweight, and you can go up to 9000 RPM. Okay, so I hope you guys learned something from this compression ratio part 2, and happy boosting. Go for high compression and high boost, but tune with discretion. Enjoy! Okay guys, press the like button if you guys like this video, and share with your friends if you think this video will benefit them. Subscribe for more videos, and I'll share more insights of 2JZ engine building. See you!